Hey, George here. Welcome to this video where I show you how to play Locomotive Breath by Jethro Tull on guitar and harmonica. So Locomotive Breath came out on the album Aqualung in 1971. And the song was written by Ian Anderson, the band's lead singer, flutist, songwriter. He played acoustic guitar. Okay, so let's just, let me give you a quick demonstration, and then we'll talk about it. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, so that's the very first part. So that's E minor, G, D, to E minor. Okay, and I'm gonna mute the strings with my little finger barring it all the way across, and that way you can mute the strings. So that rhythm starts on the end of one. So if we count it, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and the end is an upstroke, and 2, and then the G is on 3, downstroke, D is on 4, downstroke, and E minor is on 1. And then we have the muted downstrokes. 2, 3, 4, 1. And 2, and 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. And 2, and 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. In the shuffling madness of the locomotive breath comes the all-time loser. Then we're gonna go to B7, which is here, and we're gonna muffle it just by laying it down, and we're gonna muted downstrokes. 2, 3, 4, 1. D on 4, 4, E minor on 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. And 3, 4, 1. 3. Do that again. 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to go into the chorus, which brings us to G on the downstroke on 1, to A, and 2, and then we're going to go to B7. 1. And we're going to hit the upstrokes, the offbeats. And so it's 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, so those are the chords for that. So we have the E minor, the G, D, E minor. We have the part where it goes to B7. And we have the chorus where it's G, A, and then the B7. Okay, so those are the chords, the patterns. Okay, so let's take that and let's put the harmonica on it. We are in the key of E minor, which is the relative minor to G major. So I'm using a G harmonica. I'm using a Hohner Special 20. A diatonic key of G is what you need here. So what we'll do, I'll go through the chords. We'll just do this slowly. And I will play the harmonica to the melody, so you can get an idea of how the chords go with the melody. And then we'll just wrap it up. Okay? See if we can get through this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
Thank you.
All right. So that's the whole form of the song. There's three verses with chorus. There's the flute solo in there. I do a little harmonica bit, like the melody we just showed you. Staying on the theme of locomotive breath, I like to put a little train sound, train whistle or whatever on the beginning when I do an intro for that song. And so that's, hopefully you use that. You can put that all together and make your own version of it. You can do different feels with it. You can make it more laid back or more on top of the beat. Anyways, you can play around with that and have some fun. So thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a comment. Sign up for the mailing list and I'll send lessons to your inbox. All right, so take it easy. See you next time. Cheers. Peace.